Hi, dear Odooers. At Stealthy Wood, we have more and more customers every day, and some of them have been with us since the very beginning, so we want to reward their loyalty. To do so, we will use lists to sort them and remind us who is who. However, managing these lists manually can be time-consuming and costly, so we want to use an automated process to take care of this for us. That's why we decided to start using Pricelists with Odoo. More than sorting our customers into multiple lists, it will help us predefine discounts and prices for each product based on the customer's type. For companies like us that sell products all over the world, Pricelists can be particularly useful as they will help us sort our customers by region and take tax and currency variations into account. How convenient. We can also use it to distinguish our B2B customers from our B2C customers. They won't have the same discount or payment processes, so it makes sense to sort them into two separate lists. This will help us avoid making mistakes when invoicing. So let's go to Stealthy Wood's database to see how this all works. All right, here I am on my database. Let's go ahead and jump to the sales application. From here, we're going to go to configuration settings and we're going to activate the option to use Pricelists. Okay, so let's scroll down to the pricing section and we're going to activate Pricelists. And then we have two options. So we can choose either multiple prices per product, which is what we're going to choose for this video, or we can also choose advanced price rules based on discounts or formulas. And I cover that in another video, so be sure you check it out. All right, so let's go ahead and create a new price list since I have this option saved. Okay, so I can go to my price list by clicking on this button right here, or I can go to products, price lists. As you can see, I already have a few, but I'm going to create a new one right now for my good customers. So let's click on the create button and I'm going to call this price list good customer. All right, then below we're going to be able to select a company and then we're going to be able to add our products right here from the price list. Okay, so under the price rules tab. So let's go ahead and add one of our products. So I'm going to say my office chair, for example. All right, I can specify any variants. I can say that I would like this product to cost only $50 or whatever price for any customers who are in this price list. Okay, so for all of my good customers, I want this product to cost $50. Now I can set a few other conditions as well. I can say that it will cost $50 if they purchase a certain amount. I can add the minimum quantity here, and I can also say that this will apply between specific dates as well. But I'm gonna say that no matter how many of this item that they purchase, no matter the date or time, I just want this product to be $50 for my good customers. Okay, let's keep it simple. And then of course you can add as many products as you would like. But let's go ahead and save this the way that it is right now. And then we're gonna go back to all of our price lists, and I'm actually gonna jump on over to my public price list, and I'm gonna add the same product to my public price list. So let's go ahead and add that office chair. Okay, and I can always modify old items as well. All right, and for the public, for any customer, not my good customers, but just any other customer, I'm gonna say that the price is $70. And then we're gonna save. Okay, so now that I've added the products to my price list and have defined specific prices based on those lists, let's go ahead and decide who my good customers are. So we're gonna jump on over to the contacts application and I'm gonna select Azure Interior. Okay, to apply my good customer price list to Azure Interior, I'm gonna click on edit and I'm gonna scroll down and go to the sales and purchase tab. All right, here I'm going to be able to modify the price list that will automatically apply to this customer. So as you can see right now, it's just my basic public price list, but let's go ahead and select good customer. Then we're going to save. All right, now that we've done that, let's go ahead and see what the price list looks like in action. So we're going to create a quotation for Azure Interior. Okay, so I'm going to click on create and I'm going to select Azure Interior. Right away, we see that the price list is the price list that we set on the contact template. So good customer. Okay. And let's go ahead and add that office chair. Okay, so we defined on the price list that the price for the office chair for my good customers will be $50. So when I select office chair, I see that the unit price is indeed $50. Now, if I switch my customer, let's say Deco Addict, for example, someone who is assigned to the public price list. First of all, we see the price list change here. And if I add the same product, because we added this product as well to our public price list, I'm going to see that the unit price is different, okay? So whatever unit price we added for that product on the price list, it's going to apply here based on the price list we set on our customer template. All right, so it's so easy to give our good customers an extra deal or give some specific deals for specific customers based on their price list. That's all for this video. Thank you for watching. And if I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.